the tamarisk station. If you look at my hand, this is a branch from a tamarisk tree. So tamarisk is an invasive species that was brought to the US in the 1820s, so it is not from here. Now, it was brought because it was used as an ornamental plant at the beginning, and then afterward it was used for windbreaking as well. Now, tamarisk, even though it's not from here, has done exceptionally well growing here, which as resource managers, it concerns us because it affects the diversity of plants and animals. Now, I want everyone to, if you can take a look right here in this little bush right here. So one of the things with tamarisk is that they can grow very dense in areas. It'll be just tamarisk after tamarisk right next to each other. Now, being that they're so tightly close together and dense, they collect a lot of debris, which adds to the fuel that can cause more severe fires as well as increase the frequency behind them. So that is one way it could affect our plant diversity besides the fact that they just take over. They're not letting willows grow in, cottonwoods, which are plants that most of our wildlife need. One of the way we try to manage tamarisk as resource managers, if you look to my right, you're gonna see this tree here was cut off. This was not a tamarisk, but that is one way that it's a mechanical way of being able to control tamarisk. We will go and have groups cut them down or even pull them out manually. Now, that's just mechanical control. There's also chemical control. We will go in and actually spray herbicides, specific herbicides, to just kill off only the tamarisk in the area. We do still want to protect all the native species around it, of course.
The third method is actually biological control. So that's using one living thing to control the population of another living thing. So what we do here is we bring in tamarisk beetles. These are a natural predator of the tamarisk tree. The adults and the larvae eat the leaves, and when a tree doesn't have enough leaves, it can't make energy for itself, and so eventually, after enough predation, the tree can die. So the tamarisk beetle evolved with the tamarisk tree, and overall we don't see it really affecting native species in this area, so we're able to use it to control specifically the tamarisk tree.